dance.
Chris Wollendahl here, commissioner, manager of Say You Can Eat My Pudding, newly named Conan, Ginger Junk, O'Brien, bringing you a quick message before our draft pick, draft lottery, whatever you want to call it. I've had a couple drinks today, so I decided to make a video. I'll probably get ridiculed, made fun of, told I'm a loser, all that stuff soon, by all you guys behind my back and to my face. I don't really care. As of right now, in our league, we've had a couple changes. We've had a keeper rule change, which regarding free agents who were not drafted. If you look at the message board on the right side of your screen, just read it. You have questions, just call me, text me. I'm not going to answer anyway because I'm probably too busy doing nothing, like usual. As of right now, the draft has not been decided. There's another message on the right side of your screen. Please fill it out with date you cannot make it. So that's it for that. According to teams that are leaving our league, we have Team LeConte. See you later. Pierre Thomas, as your number one running back, isn't ever going to win you a fantasy football league, so he's gone. He really didn't feel he could compete with the likes of Chris Olandella, Joe D., Mike Suzito, maybe Derek Vitalik. Not really Derek Vitalik. But I just wanted to make you feel good, Derek. So, yeah, he's leaving. And Charlie Perullo will be taking over for him. A little bio on Charlie is. He's pretty good fantasy player. Not great. Not terrible. Goes up and down like a little crazy. But in recent years, his success has grown due to the fact that his mom had another child named James. James is a flow. James looks like Tim Lincecum, and he knows more about sports than Charlie ever has. Charlie usually brings him on as their co-manager, and I think James will probably end up picking a pretty good team. Might not be the top team this year because they really kind of have to rebuild, so, but we'll give him a shot. And then on the other front, Pineapples and Manningham, they were snipped because Tyler is cheap, and showed up late to our draft. I actually had to call a taxi, Derek Chaffee, to go pick him up and get him to our draft last year. He was one of the first people who told me he'd love to do a keeper league, but he didn't really want to, so he's out. And Ricky is going to take over. He's leaving his long lost, I don't know, little brother, big brother, whatever, or Italic, who's going to man his own team, Team R. Ricky's taking over Pineapples and Manningham. Ricky probably will have to get a co-owner because I know working at Richie Slush is really difficult, and he'll probably not be able to save up $100, even though I've given him basically 6 months notice that this league is going to happen. So 6 months at 4 weeks a month is 24 weeks. So if he saved up $4 a week, he would have his $100. But he didn't. We know that. So he'll probably bring in someone, and they'll see this video and think, what did they get themselves into? Other than that, coming up next on our broadcast will be the Fantasy Draft Lottery. I'll have two different cameras filming the draft live. It's going to be bang, 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 going crazy. I don't know what's going to happen. As you remember last year, we did the Tournament of Losers. Catalina Teabag is one. They'll get the first pick. Everything else is a weighted draft. It was all on the message board last year. You go to your fantasy, football, tabs under history. You can see last year's message boards. I'll eventually copy it over. I'm just too buzzed to really work a computer. I'm surprised this camera. This is actually my sixth try at this. I'll have some outtakes posted throughout the year to maybe spruce up some of the funness. I don't know what that meant. So other than that, next up you'll see my other personality, probably wearing a different hat. I've been trying to find some white Gucci sunglasses for that one. Right now I can't find them. So coming up next, stay tuned, Draft Lottery.
Peace.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the He Could Go All the Way Keeper Fantasy Football Draft Lottery. Just moments ago, in a room located right here, we held the draft lottery. If you look below me on this video, you can see the full video of that. It's pretty long, so I figured I'd shorten it up and just cut to the chase. I mean, everyone wants to know who got what pick. Remember, I'll reiterate once more, the draft lottery was weighted. Teams that came in first and second had one name in the hat or the jar. Teams that came in the playoffs but didn't come in first or second got two names in the jar. Everyone else got three names in the jar, except for the Catalina Teabaggers, who we know have the number one pick. But other than that, we'll go ahead and we'll reveal who's got what. Starting with the 10th overall pick in this year's fantasy football draft, it will go to Double Dwayne Bowe, who was newly renamed the Swole Train. Sorry, Bob, that's just the way it fell this year. Double Dwayne Bowe, number 10 pick. Double Dwayne Bowe. With the number 9 pick, your number 9 pick will be your defending champs, Conan Ginger Junk O'Brien. Conan Ginger Junk O'Brien with your number 9 pick. Going straight down the list here with your number 8 pick. Your number 8 pick will go to your last year's runner-up for getting Brandon Marshall. Last year's runner-up for getting Brandon Marshall. The number 8 pick. Number 8. The number 7 pick. We'll go to a team that made the playoffs last year. Didn't fare too well. Knocked out early. But it'll go to Bros Before Shankos. The number seven pick goes to Bros Before Shankos. The number six pick will go to another team who fought their way throughout the year, up and down, up and down. It'll go to Over the Hillis. Over the Hillis. Number 6. Number 5. The number 5 pick goes to a team that fought hard all year, made some moves, made some big moves last year. They're going to look to bounce back. It goes to the NWO. Good luck, Joe. Good luck, Brad. NWO. Number 5 pick. Down to the nitty-gritty here. The number 4 pick. The number 4 pick. Bobby Orr. Number 4 goes to a guy who newly acquired a team, Ricky. I think Tommy is actually going to be Ricky's co-manager. Pretty sure I heard them talking about that the other night at Hockey Town. So, good job, Rick. With the number 3 pick coming up, will be one of the best competitors I've ever played with, played against.
Yeah, not really.
Derek Ritalik and Team R. Team R, number 3 pick. With the number 2 pick, or as we already know, the number 2 pick will be the last pick that we don't know. I mean, by this point, if you did any math, you know. Goes to pretty much who it should go to. The worst team in the league last year, by record, Charlie Perullo. Perullo with the number 2 pick. Just for drama's sake,
number one pick, as we know, to our tournament of losers last year, or the champions of the losers bracket, who will probably go with Adrian Peterson this year, I would assume, goes to the Teabaggers. Number one Teabaggers. Thank you for staying tuned to this broadcast. Draft date should be decided soon. Again, can't make it. Please fill out stuff over there. Other than that, have a good night and stay tuned because Jersey Shore's up next on MTV.